Okay, here's our heart video, part two. I can only record this in 5-minute intervals. We left off last time with the blood being pumped by the right ventricle and flowing through the pulmonary artery and being delivered to the lungs on the left and on the right. The lungs are going to freshen up the blood with new oxygen. However, that blood doesn't have enough pressure to go anywhere else, so it has to return to the heart for a second pumping. In order to return to the heart, it's going to have to travel along the pulmonary veins. Now, you have pulmonary veins that are coming from the right lung, and so these are called the right pulmonary veins. You also have pulmonary veins coming from the left lung, left pulmonary veins, and they are all going to empty into this chamber of the heart that you can see in sort of a brighter red color. This chamber of the heart is, see if you can guess it. Take a look at the diagram already. What do you suppose it's called? It is called the left atrium. The left atrium's job is just to hold on to that blood and to balloon outward until the time is right for the blood to be pushed into the next chamber of the heart. When that moment happens, the blood is going to move through what we call the bicuspid valve, bicuspid because it's got two flaps. Sometimes it's also called the mitral valve, and it ends up in this chamber of the heart, the left ventricle. You'll notice that the left ventricle has got much thicker muscular walls than does the right ventricle. The left ventricle is much more muscular because that's the chamber of the heart that pumps the blood with enough force to get it from the heart all the way down to your baby toe if necessary. This is the strongest part of the heart. When the left ventricle contracts, it's going to force the blood out through this valve. This is called the aortic valve. The aortic valve is a smaller semilunar valve, sort of similar in structure to the pulmonary valve. The aortic valve is going to allow blood to come out the heart and into the aorta. The aorta is the largest artery in the heart. It's also the main artery where oxygen-rich blood leaves the heart on its way to the organs of the body. You'll notice that the aorta has got three branches that come out of it just in this first section here. Those are going to service the arms and the head. The rest of the blood will continue down the aorta, which is kind of hidden behind the heart, and it will be sent to the rest of the body. We'll discuss where the blood goes as it travels to the rest of the body in the next video.